Hey, what's up, guys? It's Obsessive Mind here with my girlfriend Vanessa.
Hi.
And today we got a reaction to Chris Brown's new album. Mm-hmm. It hasn't even come out yet. I think it comes out tomorrow, but I got it early. Don't ask me how. But yeah, we have all the songs right here, so we're gonna be reacting to, yeah, the Breezy album. It hasn't come out yet. It just came out. It's gonna come out in a few hours for the rest of the people, but I'll probably upload it tomorrow. After it comes out, because
yeah.
If I upload it before, then it's gonna get like taken down for copyright or whatever. So yeah, we're gonna start off with the first song. It's called Till the Wheels Fall Off. All right, Chris Brown, Breezy album.
Summertime, but it feels cold.
And that's the one day.
Sun's out
and it's shining low.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to make it through the day. Got this darkness all around me. Told my brother we gon' slide. Till the wheels fall off. Ride, we gon' slide. Free one is fine. Fighting for our lives, but they get paid if I can find it. I'm a living legend, I'ma say it till it's time to go. Hard and play everywhere. Break no compensation for the damages. Never thought that I could feel so low. I'm grown and I still don't know. I done got it out the mud, that shit was uncomfortable. Mama worked a 9 to 5, she left me 5 lunchable.
Who is that?
Slow Dirk, probably. Yeah, Slow Dirk.
I done wrote the jail and I was on the floor like take some time off. He said no cause I kept smiling in my mugshot.
Alright, so that song was fire. Chris Brown killed it. I like his verse. I like the chorus is probably the best part of the song. I didn't like Lil Durk. I mean, I don't listen to that type of music, so it's not my favorite. I feel like that verse wasn't needed. And then Capella Gray, which I think was the third guy. You can tell he has a decent voice, but I also don't think his verse was needed for this type of song. I feel like his voice just didn't match like the vibe of the song. If it was just Chris Brown, it would have been like crazy, you know, it would have been better. But it's still a pretty good song, honestly. What do you think?
I like it. I mean, I had already heard it before.
The first part. Not with the other two guys.
Oh, I didn't even notice.
That's how you don't, cause yeah, the part he released was like a video.
Yeah.
It was just his part. That's it. It was only like a minute long.
Okay.
This version has the rapper and the other singer at the end.
And you hear less Chris Brown, like, right?
No, you hear the same amount more Chris Brown because the other choruses in the song, but you also get two artists that, in my opinion, that don't sound good. So it just dragged out the song.
Yeah.
So yeah, that song was pretty good. I mean, especially because Chris Brown's parts. I didn't really like the other two guys. 1 out of 10. I probably gave it like 1 out of 10, 6.5. Next song is called Cab, Catch a Body, featuring Fivio Foreign. No idea who that is.
Mama, you said she wanna stay, she on the pole. She understand, she got a key, she wanna go. I know that she ready, she'll find out tonight. I got a feeling we finna be go.
I like this.
She was fine. Better not give me.
I know where. I heard it too.
You better not give me a rap like this. The party in the background is fire. So I think that one so far is by far like the best one. I mean, we're only two songs into it, But it's way better than the first
one. Yeah, I like it a lot more.
The vibe, the beat, the chorus, the vocals, everything. Also, the rapper on it, no idea who he is. Like, I didn't really like his verse because he wasn't saying much of shit. But he fit the song better than the other rappers in the first song. So that song's better. Out of 10, I probably gave it a 7. All right. So next song is called Pitch Black. I think Pitch Black is a song that he previewed like 5 years ago and never released. So I'm really excited for this one. Oh, that's Anderson .Paak. In the pitch black cause of my baby. Here we go. Take it off of me, baby. Here we go. Loving you in the dark and what you reaching for. And my diamond shining right around like the vision.
You just sound so good. You should already know
it's right here. This is the best one so far. So this one so far is the best one. So like the more you listen to the album, the better it gets. Like 4 or 5 years waiting for the song. I think it's been like maybe 3 years, something like that. Maybe I'm exaggerating, but he previewed this years ago, so it's kind of cool to finally get to hear it. Definitely the best song so far in the album. Out of 10, I'll probably give it a 8 out of 10. So yeah.
His voice sounds so angelic, like, yeah, so good.
So this song's called Possessive, featuring Lil Wayne and Young Blue. After this, I'm gonna listen to Drake's album, see the difference in
I've
talent.
Heard a lot of things about it. You can feel it in your bones. Try to do what he never did.
Set the tone. I wrote this shit for the most beautiful love that I ever know. I want to do your mama remember me. She go out crazy. I might get out of her ass. But you know I got good. This song is good as fuck, especially Chris Brown and Lil Wayne. I didn't really like Young Blue, the first guy. I don't think he's a good rapper nor a good singer, but whatever. I could have done without him in the song. Lil Wayne completely killed it. He's a fucking legend. Chris Brown, of course, he's gonna kill it. It's his own song. But yeah, I still think I like Pitch Black better than Possessive. So what do you think?
I like it. I think it's
a little too long. Especially because that other guy.
Yeah, that, like you said.
Young Blue, he doesn't sound that good.
Yeah.
Man. Still a good song because of Breezy, but I could have done without
Lil
it.
Lil Wayne were good.
The other guy,
good.
Not so much.
The first one was like,
it's whatever.
Yeah.
Out of 10, I probably gave that one a 6.5. So next song is called Addicted, featuring Lil Baby. You pretty with it, got a few problems, but it's all right because she's been dealing with them. Sometimes she kind of.
I like the other one better.
I like him in the first rapper. This is my first time ever listening to Lil Baby. I know Chris Brown's part is gonna be fucking good as shit.
It's gonna sound so good. It's good.
Looking like a dive if I see my ex.
she gon' be talking. Savage, she broke the pussy like it's a tongue. Bring it over here, cause you know what I'm into. All my baddies with no baggies, where you at, where you at?
Let me know, yeah. Let you be. Man, it's unfair how talented Chris Brown is, man. It's just, his voice is just too fucking good, man. It's just crazy. This is my first time ever listening to Lil Baby. I didn't really like it. I know he's extremely popular, but I feel like he ruined the song.
Yeah, I would probably listen. I definitely am going to listen to the song, but I would have to skip Lil Baby's part.
Or find a version on YouTube without his verse on it.
But that song is
fucking
so
good
amazing.
As shit, man. I think this one, if it didn't have Lil Baby, it would be the best one so far in the album. I think out of 10, I'll probably give it a 8 out of 10. All right, next song is called Call Me Every Day. Oh, we've heard this one already.
Have we?
Yeah. I'm going to just play it anyway. I don't know if she's heard it. I heard it because he released it a couple days ago. If I say I love you, then I'll tell you like so. Show you everything when I get tonight. This one's good as fuck too, man. So yeah, we had already heard that one. It's good as fuck. Chris Brown, of course, he killed it. I think this one's one of the best ones so far in the album. His vocals, the vibe.
I love the last one. The last one's so good, except for Lil Baby's part. The other one's
the vibe on this one is so fucking good,
it's
man.
Different.
I'll give it a 7.5 out of 10. This song is called Closure. The next one featuring her.
Okay.
It's probably gonna be good because her is fucking good as shit. That one was also really good. I would have preferred for this song to be like a slower song because they're just, I know her has a really good voice. I feel like this song didn't do her voice and her talent justice. So I wish it was a slower song with like them together and a slower song, you know. Still pretty good. I'll probably give it like a 6.5 out of 10. Definitely not, still really good, but not my favorite from this album.
I think it was good. I think she sounded great. I think Chris Brown sounded great.
All right, well, I think she liked it more than I did. So this song is called Need You Right Here, and it's featuring Bryson Tiller. So this is probably going to be like R&B. Need you right here. You know what I like. Drip sliding, turn into a beast soon as I get behind it. I have been putting my face in it. My God, don't tell me that you're leaving. I'll give you something to believe in. You know it ain't no limit to getting naughty. You get me started, I'm finna finish on your body. You know what I like, it's gonna get there. She like, now you wanna come around. Now you wanna go downtown. Crazy how these things turn down. You don't want to got it like that. You're making me proud. Cause I know a girl who thinks that she don't. Why did you hear my mom? Really, yo, it's all up to you. I. Song was pretty good. Again, Bryson Tiller and Chris Brown, I would have expected it for it to be like a R&B song, like a slower beat, slower instrumental. Because I feel like they could have done something better with that. Still pretty good. Not my favorite from the album, though. So I think out of 10, I'd probably give it a 6.5 out of 10.
Yeah, it sounds good. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
But it's not like my favorite either.
Yeah, I know they both have such good voices. Yeah. They could make such a good song together if they chose the right instrumental. Still pretty good, mm-hmm. but they could have done way better. So next song, song number 9 is called Sex Memories featuring Ella May. Or Ella May. Again, like Ella Mai, like she has a beautiful voice, so I hope they do like some R&B,
that.
You know? But from the beat, it doesn't sound like that.
Woke up to a text from you, they said, are you sleeping? Knowing that when I come alive in the evening. Yeah, that's the type of shit I like. Yeah. Promise when I do it to you, I'ma do it right. Put them legs up in the sky. Sex memories.
This was really good. I think this one's one of the best ones from the album so far. This one's really good. I feel like the song with her could have been more like this or even better. But yeah, Ella Mai killed it. Chris Brown killed it. I like the song. I like the beat. This one's one of the best ones. I give it an 8 out of 10.
I'll give it a 9.
9 out of 10? Well, I give it an 8 out of 10.
So good.
Yeah, this was one of this one, Pitch Black and Addicted, so far are my favorite ones.
I forgot the name for
it. This song is called Mm-mm, featuring Est. G.
Can I get a taste?
That's fire already.
Can I get a taste?
Yeah.
Tell me what's your flavor. Put that lesson in my face at school, y'all. This ain't the type of situation that you used to. I'm trying to eat that pussy even though you boot up.
That was fire too, especially the chorus.
That ruined it already.
I think you ruined that shit, man. This song was also fire. I just feel like the fucking guy ruined it, man. I don't know what the fuck is up with Chris Brown just putting these random ass rappers that nobody fucking knows.
And they
don't sound good, and they ruin the fucking song, man. Put somebody that has fucking talent, like a good voice, and do something good with it, but they just ruined the song. Chris Brown's part was fire, like always. But then he brings that random-ass fucking rapper, and they ruin it. That song could have been so much better without that guy. Still pretty good. I'd probably give it a 6.5 out of 10.
No. I would give it...
7 out of 10. 7 out of 10.
Sure, he ruined it, but Chris Brown's part was so amazing. And the guy didn't rap for too long, so it didn't completely ruin it, you know?
Like, yeah, the first one we listened to... Yeah, but it just pissed me off, man.
Yeah, but...
I thought this fucking album was gonna be more R&B, man. What the fuck is this?
I like it.
It's still fire as fuck. Every song he sounds really good in. some songs I like better than others, but I thought it was gonna be more R&B. So hopefully some of the next songs coming up are more like slower.
Yeah, are we even halfway there?
11. All right, next song is called Psychic, and I know this one has Jack Harlow in it.
I know it's late, but there's so much I can offer you. I know you can't get these party promoters off of you. I know that tequila aggravates you.
I love it.
And that
so
little
good.
Body that yeah. you got is like a cheat code. You a sweetheart, but I know that you a freak, though.
This is my favorite one. 100%.
I don't have to say shit because I feel like you know what I'm thinking.
So yeah, this one's really, really fucking
yes,
good, man.
Yes, this one's my favorite one. No question about
Chris
it.
Chris Brown killed it. Jack Harlow yes. completely killed that shit. It's definitely one of the best ones of the album. I'll give this one a 8 out of 10.
10.
There's no, 10. Chill the fuck out. Like, there might be a better song. What
I
the fuck are you going to do there?
Come on. Who are the other features that he has?
It's not about features. He's got solo songs.
It is about features.
No.
They
I prefer
it.
his solo songs better. There's a bunch coming up. Okay, so I'm going to give it an 8 out of... I'll give that an 8.5 out of 10. This one's probably like the better one with Pitch Black and Addicted and the song with LMA. So this one was really good. Next song is called Show It featuring Blast. No mm-hmm. idea who the fuck that is. So hopefully it's not another fucking rapper that ruins that shit.
Baby, you ain't gotta do too much. When I get it easy, love is amazing. And every time I feel your touch.
Recording 47 minutes already.
Yeah. So it just keeps getting better. I don't know. This
one's
good. So good.
This one was really fucking good, man. I love that upbeat. It's just so different. His vocals were the best in this song for sure. He was singing his heart out. This one of the best ones of the album. I'll give it a 8.5 out of 10.
You think the other one was better?
I gave the other one 8.5 as well.
Oh, okay.
I've given like the best ones 8
They're
to 8.5.
So they're both really good. This was amazing too.
Yeah, this one's really yeah. fucking. I like the
Chris
best one.
Chris Brown. He sounds so.
Yeah, he sounds so.
And he does so much with his voice. It's
yeah.
crazy.
This one, I think, is one of my favorite ones for sure. I've given my favorite ones like 8 to 8.5, mm-hmm. so they're on the same. I want to save that. Oh, I think this one's going to be my favorite one. I already heard part of it, so. Sleep at Night. 13, Sleep at Night. Already, bro.
You've been in no perspective, subjective.
This one.
I've showed you the snippet before.
I know.
No.
Whatever helps you sleep at night. Why you still try?
gonna be part of my end. After 7 months, I know we're blind. But
yeah, I think that's my favorite song so far in the album. Fucking beautiful, man. Those vocals, the falsetto, the lyrics, the slow R&B, man. That's what I like from Chris Brown. No other artist to fucking ruin it either, you know? He just fucking beautiful, man.
Yeah, considering that...
yeah, that this one's my favorite one so far. 9 out of 10. What do you think?
I agree.
Best one so far?
Yeah.
So next song is called Passing Time, number 14.
Featuring anyone?
No, solo. I think the first songs were like features.
Okay.
Why won't you let me leave? Fucking up more than a bag, you fucking up friends.
This
was, in my heart is in your hands when I die. Do you believe in life after love? Cause I've been thinking we both had.
Too good, man.
God damn it. I'm gonna make you buzz, but I need you to pick up what you say. Time after time, I tell you why again. Why won't you let me leave? Don't start nothing, and it won't be nothing.
Another fucking
amazing
song, man. Like,
yeah,
I don't even know. Like, it's impossible to choose a favorite one, man. Mm-hmm. I think it's gonna be easier to choose the ones that you don't like as much.
Yeah, definitely.
Which was like, I think one or two, because the other artists ruined it. But so far, man, so, this song was fire. I'll give it a 7.8 out of 10. Yeah.
Okay.
Next song is called Warm Embrace, but we've listened
heard
to
this
it.
One.
We've listened to Warm Embrace like 10 times, probably more, probably 40 times, honestly. Warm Embrace is one of the best ones from the album as well. Like, I love the whole song. I actually watched the video yesterday a bunch of times. I'm not going to listen to it again because we've listened to it so much. I'll give Warm Embrace, it's one of my favorite ones from the album so far as well. So I'll give it a 8 out of 10 as well. So next song is called Forbidden, number 16. It's kind of like Michael Jackson. This shit was, like she was just saying, it's so different, but just fucking good as the other ones. I think this was one of my favorite ones. I'll give this one 9 out of 10. That's like Michael Jackson level right there, man. I think Chris Brown's better than Michael Jackson and more talented. People are going to hate me. Go fuck yourself. That's just my opinion. Chris Brown over Michael Jackson any day in my eyes. All right, so... this song is called Badder or Bad Than a Bitch? Beach?
Beach.
No, I think they misspelled it. I don't know if it's a beach or...
Bad Than a Beach.
Bad Than a Bitch.
Bad Than a Beach.
Badder Than a Bitch?
No.
Bad Than a Beach.
Maybe it's meant that all right. way, but...
Alright, so... this song number 17 featuring Tory Lanez.
She fucking good, I'ma put her in a feature. I'ma put her in a fish. I fuck her good, you can tell I was a freezer. I'm out of hood, her mama robbed us a feeling. I hit it so good, her mama, you owe me some. Her mama bad, and she bad.
I think this one, it's pretty good.
I liked it.
Well,
it's not better than the others.
It's not one of my favorite ones. It's good. Don't get me wrong. Chris Brown, like I said, he never makes anything bad. It's definitely not one of my favorite ones.
I don't think Tory Lanez ruined it.
It's just not my type of song.
Yeah.
So I'll give this one a 6.5 out of 10. In the beginning, I gave one or two like a 6.5 as well.
But it deserved it because it was not good. It was not good because it's the first rapper.
The other two rappers, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. So this one, I'll give a 6.5 out of 10. That's how you know the album's good, when you're not going lower than a 6.5, which 6.5 is like pretty good.
And we were, I don't know about you, but I was
I feel like I'm gonna have to go back and like
re-rate
a couple of the first ones, because I feel like I went too low on them. This song is called Survive the Night, number 18. I'm just trying to survive the night and take my own advice and never love again. It's only you by my side, I've had enough again. Yeah. Who told you you get to decide the way I'm feeling inside? I'm fucking over it. If I move on, then you won't hear about it. I've been away enough to feel about it. Another banger, she was fire. Yeah, I like his solo songs better than the ones with features, man, because nobody ruins them. I'll give that one a 7.5 out of 10, right?
Yeah.
All right, next song is called Dream, number 19. I think this is my favorite one so far.
Really?
Yeah. I can't choose, man. That one was really, really fucking good, man. Like, yeah, that one's one of the best ones from the album as well. I gave that one a 9 out of 10. I would say 9.5. 9 out of 10. That one's way too fucking good, man. Yeah, still not a single bad song from the album, by the way. Like, there have been a couple bad parts, and that's because the other artists, you know? It's not even because of Chris Brown. So, yeah, what do you think? You like that one?
Yeah, that one was really good.
All right, so next song is called Slide. It's impossible to fucking choose like which song is gonna be your favorite, because they're all so fucking good. And Chris Brown is 1,000 times better than Drake, bro. It's no comparison there, man. There's so much
talent.
Like, his voice is just so unique, man. This song fucking good as shit. I'll give this one a 8 out of 10. Next song is called Harder. So I feel like the first half of the songs were like features. Mm-hmm. Second half is all solo shit.
Except for the Tory Lanez.
But that was in the first half.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, okay.
It was like three songs ago.
It's been like six songs.
Like four songs.
21, Harder. I can already tell, man. Good too. Yeah, I feel like the album just keeps getting better the more you listen to it, man. Yeah, this 9 out of 10 as well, man. It's so fucking good. The only reason I'm not giving the ones I've given 9s, 10s, is because I'm like, just in case it's like a better one, you know? But if I don't find a better one by the end of the album, then you can basically, you can put every song 1 point higher than what I gave him. So all the 9s will be 10s, all the 8s will be 9s.
Yeah.
That shit was fucking beautiful, man. Alright, so this song coming up is called On Some New Shit. And yeah, I know I'm gonna love this shit because I heard the snippet. Number 22. Fucked it up. Yeah, the filter. Like, yes, you know, can't you hear that it sounds like drowned? It sounds like it's inside something. They fucked up the filter. That song was fucking too fucking good, man. I just feel like they ruined, like, maybe they uploaded the wrong file or something, because I feel like it has too much filter. So hopefully they upload the right one later on when they actually release the album in a couple hours.
I think it's amazing.
But yeah, that song is too fucking good. Definitely, I'll give that one a 9.5. That one's my favorite one so far. Next song is called Luckiest Man. I think there's two left. Luckiest Man and then Iffy.
Oh, I heard before the video, I listened to like 10 20 this seconds one? Of it. Woke up in the middle of you, feels just like the middle of spring. Nothing left to do but a ring. Consider me the luckiest man in the world, cause you're my girl. Wake up in the middle of you, feels just like the middle of spring.
So yeah, that song was also good as shit, man. It's just impossible with Chris Brown, man, to choose a favorite. There's one more song and it's Iffy. It came out like 6 months ago. I'm not gonna listen to it again because I've heard it. And honestly, Iffy is my least favorite song of the album. So, lots of really good fucking songs.
All of them are so good.
Yeah.
All of them.
Lots of really good fucking songs. Lots of good songs. And one or two songs that are just good. So good, really good, fucking beautiful. There's like not a single bad song in the fucking.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Like expected. He's yeah, not yeah. disappoint. Yeah. Always like good as shit.
So many songs I'm gonna go and just replay right definitely, after the finish definitely. The fucking video, man, because they're so fucking good. I think between all, out of all of his albums, this is definitely top three for sure. I think Heartbreak on a Full Moon's. Oh, it's so good, man.
That was my favorite.
Fame. I love Fame as well. Royalty. Indigo is not one of my favorites. This one's way better than Indigo. So this definitely, I think it's top three of his albums for sure. So the more I listen to it, the more I'll be able to come to a conclusion because all these songs are going to be in repeat. Mm-hmm. So all in all, definitely one of the best albums of the year for sure.
Yes.
Definitely, I think he's the most talented artist of our generation. He's crazy talented. I think he's better than Michael Jackson, more talented than Michael Jackson. Say whatever the fuck you want. I'm gonna react to Drake's new album and compare it to this. See the difference in talent. And I know Drake's album's probably gonna be more popular because it's fucking Drake, but talent wise, nobody can touch Chris Brown in this album.
But just I've seen a lot of like memes and.
Roasting Drake, yeah, right?
Yeah, so it's probably not his best.
Yeah. Well, hopefully, because... Yeah. Not hopefully, but I know it's not going to be nowhere near as good as fucking Chris Brown's shit. But yeah, I don't know. That's all I'm going to say, I guess. That's the reaction.
Thank you guys for watching such a long reaction.
If you watch it. Yeah. Most people are not going to get to this fucking part. Maybe one or two people. So if you're one of those one or two people that watches till the end, thank you. And yeah, man, like I said... Chris Brown's untouchable, way too much fucking talent. So yeah, you guys have a good
rest of your day,
night, whatever. All right, take care. Bye.